Knowing what kind of investment is best for you and how they stack up is a question most people have. So today we look at how term insurance plus a mutual fund stack up against a variable life insurance or VUL. I'm Edric Mendoza and this is On The Money. Joining us on the show today is Naresh Krishnan, President and CEO of SunLife Grepa Financial. Welcome to the show, Naresh.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me as well.
Sure, yeah. It's been a topic that we have gotten numerous questions on, so I'm going to go straight to it. Your views, being in the financial services industry for many years, perspectives on mutual funds and term life versus VUL.
Yeah. You know, we are under the impression that all VULs are the same and all mutual funds are the same. Mm-hmm. And that is where the differences comes in. Within the mutual fund itself, you have front-end load funds, you have back-end load funds, mm-hmm. then you have a mixed ones, a mm-hmm. blend of both, then you have no load funds. Mm-hmm. And we do have similar scenario in a VUL product as well. So you have products which have a front-end 5% bid and offer spread, mm-hmm. which is very popular in the past in the Philippine environment. Mm-hmm. Now you have a new breed of VUL products that are coming in, which don't have any front-end charges, but they are designed to be back-end loaded products so mm-hmm. that customers can stay there mm-hmm. for a longer period of time. Mm-hmm. So you do have different solutions available. Mm-hmm. So what I would request your viewers and yourself is, without taking a generic terms, we need to get into the product. Mm-hmm. We need to compare the feature. We have to look into pricing. Then we can get a better appreciation.
Okay.
But to answer your question simply, today in the Philippines, we have products mm-hmm. in the VUL segment mm-hmm. which offer the same value proposition, similar to a mutual fund, and which have cost of insurance much, much more lower than even the term insurance. Mm-hmm. So you do have a solutions that are offering better value proposition to the customer within the VUL platform.
Interesting.
But don't forget, yeah. I love mutual funds, I love term insurance as right, well. Right.
You said that from a cost perspective,
yeah.
if you want to compare, the closest apple to apples comparison that yeah. you can give is mutual fund packaged with in a VUL versus mutual fund together with term. You're saying that you can get the same mutual fund type. For example, let's talk equity fund.
Yeah.
Okay. So you can get a mutual fund that is an equity fund.
Yeah.
And you can get a VUL that has a equity fund, mutual fund component.
Yeah.
Now you were saying earlier that you can actually get the life insurance component in a VUL that will cost you cheaper or cost you less than getting the same value coverage in a term life insurance. Is that yeah. correct?
Very true.
Okay.
It's very simple. Now, mm-hmm. when you buy two products independently, mm-hmm. so there are independent distribution costs, independent mm-hmm. maintenance costs, servicing costs, etc. Mm-hmm. So clearly that is where it will be a little bit more expensive. Mm-hmm. So when you have a blended product, most of these general costs to support the product is distributed,
I see.
That's where you get the efficiency, and that is being passed on to the customer. So if you have a neck-to-neck comparison, mm-hmm. Which I did it before coming on the show,
okay,
to
sure.
be 100% sure,
okay.
Clearly we have our some of the products clearly offering better value proposition on a VUL basis rather than on a standalone term and a mutual fund basis.
Okay. Yeah. So I mean, if we were to put nuts and bolts into that, so let's say 100,000 peso premium
yeah.
or 100,000 peso total investment amount,
okay.
premium and mutual fund.
Okay.
If I was to put that amount mm-hmm. in a VUL
okay.
versus splitting that up in a mutual fund of the same type
yeah.
as the VUL and the term life, you're saying that I would get better value for money in the VUL.
I'm saying there are products available in okay. the Philippines that offers better value because there are you have so many products with
sure.
different pricing.
Sure.
So some of them may not, some of them are.
Right.
So we do have both available in the Philippines today.
Okay.
That's the message I'm giving you.
All right, right. But if we were just to just using that simple example,
yeah.
Would it be because of the fees you mentioned, which makes
yeah.
a lot of sense,
yeah.
the fees in processing, handling, etc., would be cheaper for the VUL product, which means if I was to ask myself, okay, with the 100,000, the coverage that I get for the combo VUL and the coverage that I get for the individual term life here
yeah.
would be the same, and my mutual fund amount that I'm putting in will also be the same, which one would give me more?
There are products which are more expensive than mutual fund and term insurance.
Okay.
And there are products
that
which
are cheaper
than mutual.
So
that's
which
why you need to compare.
Right.
You need to compare each of the product,
sure.
and you need to look at the pricing,
okay.
and you need to have a neck-to-neck comparison to get a better appreciation.
Okay.
So if you do the window mm-hmm. shopping in the market, there are solutions available in the VUL platform, which
mm-hmm.
offer, for example, you can 100% of your premium mm-hmm. straight away goes into the investment fund.
Okay.
And if you keep it for 5 years and above, there is no other charges.
Okay.
And whatever is the insurance component, there is a small cost of insurance, mm-hmm. which is much, much more better than even buying a term product separately. And that is available today in the Philippines.
Okay.
And these are very popular products for the last 2 years.
Okay.
And people are buying tons and tons
of
it. The best way to do is maybe speak to the financial advisor, mm-hmm. to speak to the branch manager, mm-hmm. and you can get the information
sure.
and compare it
sure.
and take it
and do your numbers from there. Okay, but it's good to know that there are those options.
Yes.
Because people have the impression that it's always more expensive if you get the combo.
It used to be,
right.
used to be, but now the new breed, and mm-hmm. that's the beauty of competition, mm-hmm. correct? So it brings in the best. And customer is the beneficiary in the end.
Yeah.
And that's what is happening right
okay.
now.
Okay, so maybe we can direct our discussion in terms of the advantages there instead, or maybe the personalities that would be suitable for a VUL combo or those that want it split.
All these products mm-hmm. are good products, and all of them have certain objective to create, address certain needs of
sure.
the customer, create some value proposition for the customer.
Sure.
So a mutual fund has its role in your portfolio.
Mm-hmm.
A term insurance has its role,
mm-hmm.
and a VUL has its role.
Sure.
And I'll try to show you where it becomes
roles?
Different,
mm-hmm.
you understand. No? See, for example, in the VUL product, let's say, it mimics the same mutual fund from an investment and exposure to capital markets and
mm-hmm.
investment gain, etc.
Mm-hmm.
But let's say you are saving for a children's education, correct? And you are planning to send the kid to a college in the next 5 year period, and
mm-hmm.
you have some cash and you want to build it for that particular purpose,
mm-hmm.
you know? So you put it in a VUL product. If the market is working in your favor and your investment is growing,
mm-hmm.
the insurance component is only for up to 125% of the premium,
sure.
you understand, no? So the moment your investment assets grow beyond 125%, there is no cost of insurance,
mm-hmm.
okay? And it becomes pure mutual fund in its true sense, and you're only growing your funds. And if the kid goes to college, you enjoy the funds, send him to college.
Mm-hmm.
That's all good scenario, which mm-hmm. I hope everybody has it. You
sure.
understand? But in truth is, it may not happen that way. Let's say you try to build up the same thing in 2005, you know, and till 2007 your investment has been doing extremely well. And then you have this 2008 comes
mm-hmm.
in, and you see your portfolio is like halved, okay? Now imagine something unfortunate happens to the family,
mm-hmm.
okay? So you lost the breadwinner, and you lost your investment pool,
mm-hmm.
and then you need to send your kid to college, you are in a difficult situation.
Mm-hmm.
So in a product like VUL, the moment if the investment value goes below the 125%, whatever is the difference between the value of your assets and the 125, the insurance kicks in.
Oh,
you understand?
Okay. No?
And in this
okay.
situation,
mm-hmm.
even if the market is working against you and things are not doing in your favor,
mm-hmm.
still the kid can go to the college
mm-hmm.
and then get educated. And that's why these products are there specifically to address goals,
mm.
needs-based
mm-hmm.
saving. You understand?
Now, what type of personality would you recommend for the just mutual fund
and
term
the term
life.
Insurance. Yeah. I actually recommend this product for people who have not decided what kind of protection they want.
Mm.
And, you know, for example, if you're not sure
mm.
and if your cash flow is not sure,
mm-hmm.
you know, then the best thing is at least have a term insurance,
mm.
okay? And then once you figure out what is the protection you need,
mm-hmm.
what is your cash flow, and accordingly you can upgrade into other products.
Mm-hmm.
The weakness here is the price is cheaper when you are young, but as you get older, it becomes expensive.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the biggest challenge is when you become older and your commitment becomes more,
mm-hmm.
you may have less affordability to pay when it is increasing.
Mm-hmm.
So, do you want to front load your expenses when you are healthy and you are at
mm-hmm.
your peak
I
of
think
your
so.
Career,
yeah, yeah.
you know? So this is where the dilemma comes
I
in,
see.
You understand? So even though they think it is cheaper,
mm-hmm.
it may be a strain on you at a particular
longer
age
term.
And stay stage in life, you know. So that's why people prefer whole life products. Excellent. Because what you're doing is you are able to have a same price throughout the life of your product, and you are able to upfront most of your
when
expenses,
you still can.
Etc.
Makes sense.
And but if you want to have some cash value so that it'll help you in your retirement, you buy a whole life with an anticipated endowment, so and you address that particular needs. So that's why I always believe life insurance products are like the Lego blocks. You know, you can buy something for your immediate need, and as you build your cash affordability, you can actually fill up the gaps. You know, you start with a core protection, then you go for health, hospital income, critical illness, and you build it up slowly.
Excellent, Naresh. You opened my eyes to VUL. We're going to have questions from our viewers now.
Sure.
We're going to pause for a short break. Stay tuned. On the Money, we'll be right back. Welcome back to On the Money. Let's check what Salve Duplito has for us in Salve Says.
There are financial termites that eat into everybody's savings. It's a reality in our country where inefficiencies abound and financial institutions simply pass on the cost of these inefficiencies to unwitting consumers like us. Companies don't educate you and I about these financial vampires. Most hide them in fine print. Good thing some big banks display them properly on their websites, but they are more the exception than the rule. One example are bank fees, which in the Philippines are very high compared with other countries. These fees have been going up steadily. ATM fees are now at around 15 pesos per transaction when you are using another bank's ATM. If you're like most depositors, you use the ATM around 3 times per week and you don't think twice about using ATMs of other networks, and that amounts to 2,160 pesos per year. Another is the cost of maintaining bank accounts. We pay 300 to 500 pesos when we can't maintain the average daily balance. There are dormancy charges of 200 pesos. Some banks even charge depositors 500 pesos for closing a deposit account within 1 month of opening. When you're maintaining a checking account, you need to be aware that if your check bounces, you get charged more than 2,000 pesos. The charges for overdraft protection. That's when you borrow from the bank when you don't have enough money to fund an incoming check, are huge at more than 20% of the amount. So be careful. Is there any way to avoid paying hefty bank fees? Yes, if you're an OFW. Some banks have started to offer zero maintaining balances since early 2000. I've actually opened an OFW account. The bank offered it to me, and it's pretty cool not to have those fees hanging over me. The second financial termite is active fund management fees. I've said this before, and I'll say it again. Most funds charge 1.5% to 2% active management fees. And here's the thing. You pay those fees whether your money is doing well or not. No less than Stanford University's William Sharp has written that fees shave off around 1/3 of your potential earnings over time. Some people don't really mind paying that much. They tell me it's better to pay that than not have any investment at all. But you should be at least aware that you're paying that much. Well, some people, well, let's say most Filipinos, don't even try to understand the cost that they're paying. Termites operate in the dark. Financial termites are the same thing. So the only solution in stamping them out is for all of us to be a fee Nazi. We consumers need to band together, know our rights, and make noise. We need to make smart financial choices so that companies will know that they cannot reel us in with advertisements. They need to offer value for money because we're all smart with our finances.
Still with us is Naresh Krishnan, President and CEO of SunLife Grepa Financial. And of course, Melissa Hercule with your money questions. Mel, here's the discussion.
I know, finally. I'm so excited, yeah. And I think our viewers are excited as well. So great, lively first half.
It's been very, very helpful.
Yeah. Thank you.
Very
thank
insightful.
You. Thank you.
Our first question comes from Ace, who asks, Susie Orman says that it's better to have a term insurance and invest the difference in mutual funds or stocks. Any thoughts? Do the benefits outweigh the drawbacks compared to VULs? And which one is better when it comes to fees?
The old generation of VUL products were seen to be expensive because it was in those days where you had double-digit interest rate. Mm. Still,
right.
People felt value for it. But today, under the current interest rate environment, customers are asking for better value proposition.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why we have new breed of products available in the Philippines for the last 2 years, where customers are able to get the same value as a mutual fund and much, much more cheaper insurance coverage and a blended and a convenient manner made available to them. And so that's why in today's context, this question is not relevant question because we do have solutions that are on par, if not better, available. So, you know, but all the three are good solutions and I'm happy that people are at least having one or the other.
Mm-hmm. That's right. But what about the option of a whole life insurance plus mutual fund versus a VUL? That would be more of an equal comparison, wouldn't it?
You know, these products serve very different needs, you understand. At the moment you go into a whole life, it talks about income replacement need of the family, you know. If something happens to the breadwinner, how we are gonna get alternative income source, and this product is supposed to address that particular need.
Mm-hmm.
But the VUL product and the mutual fund products, they address very different needs, which is basically wealth accumulation, so you keep adding and building it up, and wealth building so that you're investing in capital market instruments so that you can grow your returns, and then how you are preserving it. So clearly, I think the VUL product and mutual fund products are more designed towards wealth management, whereas the whole life products are more designed towards protecting the income. So, and both are needed, you know. That's the message that I wanted to give you. The insurance industries have a wide range of products, and the reason why we construct the product suite that way is people have different needs at different life stages, and these products address that at different point in time. So all products that are provided by the life insurance industries are relevant to the society. It is needed, and it has to be used at the right context and the right opportunity.
Okay. Actually, I have a question about the VUL products, because there are different types, right?
Yeah.
So there is the one-time pay, and then there is the regular pay.
Yeah.
Which is better suited to what type of personality and what purpose?
It's a very good question, you know. The single pay product is predominantly an investment heavy product. You know, basically, in the example that I was quoting, we have products where 100% of the premium goes into an investment fund.
Right.
And there is a small insurance coverage, which is 125% of the premium you're paying to ensure that whatever is your savings objective are met in case if something goes wrong. You know? So those products are heavily towards investment and wealth building. You know,
but it's the more like insuring your investment.
Exactly.
Okay.
You know, insuring the objective of your investment.
Yes.
You know, children's education or whatever it is. You know, but when you get into a regular pay product, the emphasis here is more of a protection, and the investment component is basically a cash flow enables you to build over a period of time and helps you to pay for some of the premium as well. So if you want protection more, then you should go for a regular premium product. But if you are wealthy, affluent, and you have substantial disposable cash available, then the single pay products are appropriate.
Okay. The next is a comment from John, who says, for regular pay VUL, the fund value of the policy for the first 3 to 5 years doesn't seem to comply with the rules of investment, which is capital preservation and portfolio growth, with all the charges being deducted to the premium paid by the client.
And actually, I did indicate in my previous answer, the regular pay products are more tuned towards protection element.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why whatever is the cost get deducted and that is why people are not able to see that the investment component is growing, you mm-hmm. understand, huh? And that is a real challenge. So if you are looking at growing your capital, and then you should look at investment type products like a mutual fund or a VUL product.
Right.
But if you really need protection, which I think everybody needs, mm-hmm. then you need to look at various options available and see what is appropriate.
Okay.
The beauty of the regular pay variable life products is it allows people to contribute. Everybody cannot pay the kind of single premium amount, you understand? So you can pay small amounts and you can pay for 5 year, 10 year, mm-hmm. 20 year or whole of life. All the options are available.
Okay.
And maybe we have to choose something that is much, much more longer and you can contribute more and then build over a period of time.
So let's say you take the 5 year payment plan of VUL. When does the money that you're putting in actually go into the investment portion of that product?
It actually goes from the beginning, but it starts with a very small increment. Let's say 100% of the premium, only a small percentage goes into investment, rest goes for the insurance and other expenses, and slowly builds up over a period of time. So
it would be like a like 5% of what you're paying
goes into the
investment portion.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So the whole objective of that particular product is basically to focus on protection, and even the cash flow is helped to you can even use it to pay for future premium payment as well.
Now, Jasil asks, when is the right time to convert your term insurance to whole life or getting a one-time pay VUL mm-hmm. if you were thinking of estate planning?
I think the initial statement I made was, if you are not clear of what to do, the best thing is to buy a term insurance, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And then once you figured out what is the kind of protection that you need, and then what is your cash flow affordability, then you can decide how you can expand it into a whole life product.
Right.
Now, when we talk about estate planning, it's totally a different game altogether.
Mm-hmm.
Here we are talking about transmission of wealth from one generation to the next generation, you know.
Right.
And you have no clue when the time is going to come, where it is going to be mm-hmm. happening, you understand, no? So I presume the day you realize that you have set aside these funds and you don't need it in your lifetime,
mm-hmm.
okay, and you are giving it to the next generation, you have decided you are going to give
yes.
it to the next generation,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Because once you give back, you can't take it back.
But
in a life
right.
insurance policy, you can still change
your life,
you know, because you still have a control, you understand?
Right. Mm-hmm.
Till you die, you have an opportunity to change it. I think in the Philippine environment, we have a 20% estate tax, and that is a significant portion of the wealth.
Right.
And the only instrument that allows you to transfer your wealth without any seepage is the life insurance product.
Right.
And I think the whole life product is the best product to do that, and we should be able to do that as well.
Couldn't you transfer it while you're still alive and then pay the
donation tax?
Yeah, donor's tax instead.
It's up to you. You want to give taxes to the government. If you are looking at from a financial perspective, you want to transfer as much as possible to the next generation. I think this is the best way to
insurance
do it.
Okay, actually, speaking of that, does it ever make sense to have more than one life insurance policy?
In my opinion, what you need to look at it is, what are my needs? This is like must have, you
mm-hmm.
understand now? And what are my wants? They're like good to have, you
mm-hmm.
understand now? So what you do is, you evaluate the must have and please have it.
Mm-hmm.
And the evaluate good to have and look at your affordability. Can you afford it?
Yes.
And look at your cash flow, okay? Are you willing to make a commitment and make it happen? Then you can, as I said, life insurance is like a building block. So you can add up wherever there is a gap and fill up that particular gap and expand your coverage. So to answer your question, you may need more than one policy, because I don't think so you have all the money and you can cover everything at one stroke with one single policy. I think it is a little bit challenging. So I would prefer people take a phased approach, slowly build and then evaluate and take it forward.
Okay, well, thank you so much, Naresh. It was great having you.
My pleasure. Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm.
And it was an enjoyable conversation.
Definitely.
Okay, anyway, send us your money questions via email, Facebook, or Twitter, and we'll try to answer them in our upcoming episodes or on our next Q&A Friday.
VUL eye-opener, finally. Thanks again, Naresh.
Thank you.
My
pleasure.
That's our show today. I'm Edric Mendoza. Join us again tomorrow for more talk and tips so you're always right on the money.